go. Paladine not really there to zone, and Ice has done a solo smoke bottom on Rubick, so perhaps thinking they can get this early kill, although Envy's back to full HP, so he's going to have to wait for some harass here.
I mean, he's probably still right, though. Paladine is going to step a little bit too far forward, get the telekinesis, and with all that right-click damage, it's going to be real easy for Ice to pick up the first blood. Yeah. You know, Earthshaker offlane or the Clockwork offlane or something like that that is able to just get a little something out of scenarios that most other offlaners cannot.
Yeah, and they're not really expecting the Earthshaker to be like that big scary farm core here in the late game. Puppy's going to probably be more farm than Universe throughout this entire game, but this is very much just setting up, getting as much farm out of the map as possible.
Oh, man, that was not the play. Tries to go for the teleport out, doesn't actually make it. Ice turns around, gets a little more damage on Paladine, but almost like the cat chasing the mouse, the dog chasing the cat, and chasing after Ice, Furion chases after the Ancient Apparition, but in the end, it's going to be Eternal Envy, who's the supreme predator. And meanwhile, Arteezy may actually go down in the middle lane. He's got a phase shift, dodges both of those projectiles. Bian had it. Oh, what a Treant! Okay.
That Treant has done his juice. He can retire happy.
Yeah, he really can.
Well,
GP back to mid. But, Puppy, I think you need to go back to base, my friend.
A bit
I don't
of scrappy,
think the Treant's going to leave you alone.
Scrappy early game, but yeah, oh boy, Puppy needs to be careful here, actually.
Yeah, he really does. There is the Sprout ready to go, so Bian's going to be able to block out Puppy a little bit more. Looks like should still be fine, though. Puppy's okay. Draws Arteezy over here. Now the Ancient Apparition actually coming in from the side, while Arteezy takes a break from the mid lane to get some revenge on Bian, and will be able to do so.
I think too aggressive from Bian. This is still, you're 3 minutes in, Bian! We saw this last game where Wings just went a little bit too aggro in the laning stage, like there.
You know, Earthshaker, unable to do anything at the top lane, is very rapidly falling farther and farther behind, but that really is what an Earthshaker or Clockwork offlaners do. They just need some levels. Ice is going to show up. He smoked up for this position, will be able to get the pullback. Shadow comes forward, should be able to slow down Universe enough. Arteezy does come in with a Dream Cult, but there's not a whole lot of follow-up TPs here, and Arteezy silenced up, isn't actually able to get out in time, it looks like, as the orb is only going to be able to get him so much space and instant actually kills him first before Arteezy could get the kill on the support 2-for-nothing.
Puppy had to make the call like, okay, Universe, you're going up there, but if they dive you, if they make that play, we're not going to back you up. They almost have to have talked about it before the dive actually happened, and it didn't feel like that was the case.
Well, maybe they will have discussed this one. Eternal Envy is going to be able to catch Shadow here in place. The telekinesis throwback isn't going to be enough, as Shadow is caught by the cold feet, and Eternal Envy lays claim to the enemy carry. Still though, Blink is actually wrapping around here. He's got the haste rune, he's got the opportunity, the angle for the shackle shot onto Universe, should be able to finish up maybe before the Fissure. Yeah, comes out at the same time. Either way, they get the kill.
They have roll though, this could backfire.
Yeah, Eternal Envy's gonna go straight for Innocence here. He does, oh maybe not, doesn't have to jump away in time. Oh, barely, as just in time the Primal Roar is able to stop Blink, and now here comes the combo as the Arteezy is able to put a stop to a lot of this. Just the TP out from the Rubick is the only one to escape from that Dream Coil, but they get the bigger kill in the Wind Ranger. Now,
relocate back in.
Silence onto Arteezy. They've got him. A big kill there. They're going to look for a little bit more as Bian pops himself out, goes for the Sprout play. He's got the drums activated too. They have a slight movement speed advantage, but they have to be careful. A Fissure on three underneath the tier two with Eternal Envy backing them up as well. He does get silenced up, and they're going to try and right-click him down, but now the stuns come in, and Eternal Envy should be able to finish off Shadow. It is right-click damage sprouted up. Oh no, Eternal Envy's actually going to die. Shadow starts running himself away. The Fissure misses. Shadow, he has to juke his way through this one somehow, but not going to be able to do it. The Enchant Totem catches him. Bian, meanwhile, is stuck inside this awkward position. He does have a Sprout. He's going to go for it now, but Arteezy is able to jump onto him with the orb. Silence finishing him up. Again, Wings' over-aggression may be costing them this laning phase.
Yeah, trying to force it a bit too much. Take a tower with like a four-man rotation, that's one thing, but diving that deep near the tier 2 towers, they really overstayed their welcome.
Yeah, they certainly did. Arteezy going for that 10-minute rune. The Furion's going to back him up, though, and that's why Arteezy abandons hope for that rune, but they get the shackle shot surrounding Arteezy. He will end up going down. That's the combination that Wing should be able to operate with a little bit more to go for the dive. So he backs out before he gets his level 6. The rest of the team is going to smoke up, though, and still try and catch Wing shortly after they take it.
Universe cutting across, looking for the fissure opening. They do get the Primal Roar. Plink manages to get off the wind run first. Now the Primal Roar turnaround on the Universe. He doesn't manage to get off the fissure, and they get the relocate save. Universe even goes down before getting off anything. Still, though, Eternal Envy, beautiful jump in. Will be able to lay claim to two, but Arteezy's going to be the turnaround kills. They get the silence onto him and beat him to a pulp. Secret with Wings, two for two, but that was a smoke exchange. Wings, having just won a fight not too far away from the Roshan pit, as you said, they can rather easily do it. And this time around, Universe does not have a Blink Dagger to make some sort of $3 million Echo Slam play, or maybe he does. Fissure actually goes out on the three. Eternal Envy's going to be silenced up, but Universe walks straight into him with the Echo Slam. Never mind, he may have actually gotten that stolen. Ice Ice turns around, gets a minimal amount of damage onto both Secret, and they still are going to lose one to Eternal Envy as he moves forward. Eternal Envy jumps back in, goes for Innocence. He's got the backup over Arteezy. The Drain Claw locking down both of them. Arteezy marches forward. He should be able to get... Oh, couldn't quite finish off Shadow before he died. But still, it's going to be a huge win for Secret either way, as they take out four members of Wings for just Eternal Envy, and now they're going to be able to claim Roshan for themselves.
With a buyback on Nature's Prophet, an absolutely terrible fight for Wings. They're really forcing it there, perhaps. Oh, they're going to try and fight this.
Whoa, okay, the Sprout goes down. This is definitely a lineup that is dependent on Roshan, but how much can you really do with this one? Oh, they just barely managed to take away that Aegis as well as finishing off the Earthshaker. Dan, he's actually going to be able to get Highlight Eye as well. These crazy right clicks. Primal Roared at the last second, but it doesn't matter. The shot was already there, finishing off the Ancient Apparition, and now the backup. Ice Ice chops down the trees. Not good enough to be able to save the Furion. Ice Ice challenging Arteezy, though, even further, bringing back that telekinesis, and the power shot actually missed. Good
he's
phase
be cut
shift.
Off, though.
Yeah, you see on the other side, Toronto Ranger ready to go, has the silence. Arteezy knows he's trapped like a rat. He will end up going down. Somehow, Wings go from throwing the Roshan fight to kind of recovering it. Yes. Focus down one hero like the Wind Ranger with that kind of instant blink in, disable of Echo Slam, follow-up Fissure. Arteezy just used an orb offensively and is maybe going to be caught out here. Managed to dodge the Shackle Shot. He has the orb coming out, but good silence relocate play.
Probably being the pilot I play historically, so... but yeah, Shaker's sitting behind...
All right,
Envy.
Here's the play. Shackle Shot. There's the Orchid as well. The relocate is coming out. They manage to get the Fissure, but it's not going to be able to stop the Drone Ranger from finishing him off. They throw out the Echo Slam, but that's not good enough, and now Universe is going to be caught as well. They anticipated that kind of gank, I think, from maybe the Drone Ranger. I don't think they knew about the Orchid just yet.
Split Secret up. That's going to be when you're at your strongest.
Between the Ember Spirit, Puck Blink... The Universe Blink as well. There's so many ways for Secret to be able to catch you during Roshan, but they're actually going to be the ones going for the aggressive play here. Smoke up, move forward. There goes the jump. They managed to catch Shadow, trying to get the relocate out, but it's not going to be good enough. The Echo Slam actually stopping that one in its tracks, so they get two for it, and now get Tier 1 and probably Roshan with that.
Yeah. I think going for a straight up push like for the T2 mid is going to set Secret up for that exact thing, though, where they can catch you before you BKB. Mm-hmm. Like, Secret will just go for that smoke flank, but...
Shadow, oh, he's going to be spotted out here, knows it too, does manage to get the silence on the Universe, that's going to be a big one. They take him out, as well as the Ancient Apparition almost immediately. Now the Primal War is going to be wasted, the relocate forward, hoping to be able to get Arteezy, but he orbs himself away, and now here begins the TPs, 1, 2, and 3, oh, all able to make it out, Blink. Didn't have the Shackle Shot up in time. Just go straight into that Drow Ranger.
Yeah.
And challenge her in team fights.
And Envy's a player who sometimes goes for unconventional fighting items on his Ember.
Telekinesis, they get the control on Eternal Envy. They will be able to take him out, and the BKB charge used as well.
The fact he got to use BKB means he could have remnanted.
But did Wings don't know that, but they may just try and force it out of him anyway. Soon they're gonna find out that there's nothing there. It's the Tier 3 tower getting chipped away.
I swear, that Dragon Lancer range on the low ground just brings down towers, even when pushing into the enemy base.
Will Stepter leading the way, and that is going to be a silent storm by Ice Ice. Not bad, considering he had the Blink, but they're going to try and catch Blink. They manage to blow him up. Shadow is going to be accidentally up next. They get the Primal Roar Necronomicon onto him. The two big damage dealers of Wings are already gone, and they don't even need the Ember Spirit, apparently.
That just happened too fast. Wings just got completely caught out by surprise, and again, you've got to be able to get the BKBs off to get value out of them, and that's exactly what Wings were unable to do. Great initiation from Universe. All the attention from Wings initially is on that Wind Ranger who got jumped, so the IO's like, oh crap, can I relocate, save him? And it's already too late. And then they don't catch the Wind Ranger, who then gets followed up with a roar. So
this feels like another mistake, because Wind Ranger was missing a decent chunk of HP before Earthshaker managed to get the opening on him. Oh, top lane. Looks like they're going to be able to get a combo here on Puppy, and that is the gem. I'm not sure, is that... Yeah, that's actually Puppy's gem.
Yeah. Sure, Echo Slam, the Beastmaster Roar, we've seen him steal once. Buck Orb slash Coil could be good.
Yeah. Primal Roar is obviously... unlikely he'll get Ice Blast, so Primal Roar is obviously the big ability that Finesse upgrade.
Oh, and now he's been orbited as well. He committed the Yules offensively.
And that means he'll take out...
It's always a lot easier to push these side lanes against these big power teamfighting heroes who want to initiate on you, because there's fewer ways for them to actually initiate when they can't come from below. They have got to come from their high ground or from above.
Yeah, you could see plenty of vision, especially if the Sprout Paddle I Die is going to be the target here. They want to be able to take away that Ice Blast. BKB activated by Blink is going to be able to prevent a lot of the incoming damage. They get Eternal Envy instead with the Primal Roar stolen by Ice Ice, as now they look for more. Push back Blink. It's going to be three coiled up. Universe makes his entrance with an Echo Slam, trying to finish up Blink, but no! Can't quite get him in time, and now Wings will be able to save Blink, and he turns on a Universe, killing him, taking him out of the fight. RT's going to be up next. Shackle Sonic taken away. Eternal Levy goes for the two. Will be able to get both the Wiz as well as the Wind Ranger, but it cost him his own life, and now Universe may even die back here. That's 70 seconds for the Puck, 90 seconds for the Ember Spirit. Wings, with their big core still up, and now relocate in from both the Wiz as well as the Wind Ranger, they can clean up a second lane of Brax as well at top.
Yeah, knowing that both the main cores of Secret can't
fly back for Throne.
They bolt back the Wind Ranger. They can really just take out at least multiple lanes of Rax, possibly just get Radiant's the GG off of this. There's no Echo, no Roar, nothing to defend with. And Wings, all it took was one Roshan, and game goes their way.
Just like that, Secret. Couple of pickoffs, and all of a sudden that just turns into the game outright. Straight up Throne with a Draw Ranger strat. Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Secret. You thought like some of this game looked okay. The pickoffs weren't great, like Secret losing, say, Puppy at the top lane, losing Artur a little bit later. Like, those were really unfortunate deaths, but some of that game actually looked okay for Secret. Like, they were going to be